The bomb is rattling, but
oh boy,
it's a long flank coming from Glaive, but I think it's too late.
Yeah, long shot there. Fur gonna go ahead and take down the mice. And here comes a spray off a catwalk. Glaive picking up one tank. Can he grab the third and potentially win this round for Astralis? I don't know. He's gonna have to run and stop the.
Oh!
Ladies and gentlemen, Glaive has found success.
That's insane.
As four, the flank comes in.
Ooh, they actually do start to make it work as well. We fall back into a 2v3 here. It's back through. Cold Zero as well. Not the man you want to be facing off against. He's given a free frag, gifted it as he claims the head of Buster. We'll mount that one on his mantelpiece. Walks his way through as well. The bomb is going down.
Interesting. Oh, sorry. Default plant coming out from SK Gamer. They're not planting for B main, which means SK have to be playing close in towards the side. No defuse kit at their disposal. Time is of the essence. They find the first frag. Is this the 15-11?
Well, it's that excellence that we expect coming out from Kuka here. These are the situations where he can clutch, but he needs to go big. Cold Zero as well. You can never topple him. He's an absolute first contact as he spots them out. Tries to land a few shots with the pistols, but is forced back into a defensive angle. Tries to stay alive and really just wants to go for the brute force play, but instead it's Nico who's naughty with the pistols, gets a free K, hungry for more. He wants to try to do it all on his lonesome, but Snappy comes in to take the weight off his shoulders. It's just Neo remaining. Goes down filthy from Nico.
Sandwich aside from Pop. And teammate, but also helps a lot more if your teammate player wide faces gets the first frag. What a fast trade there from Yuki, but Snacks has done enough damage. Now it gets awkward for Heroic. Do
this is the catalyst, but Rubino needs to be the power player and the difference maker. Oh. But instead, he goes down. The response is there from Bayali. His reckless play won't come through. Yuki, though, up close and personal, the no scope as well. Just finding critical frag. Second off the second with the AWP as he denies the push. Flashbang goes down. Yuki! Lanimal.
Tarek and Stewie get ready to challenge. They'll both go in the checkers room for now. Tarek will get first contact. So tuck himself in the corner. There's the flashbang. You feel like he's going to do well with this one. There's the first shot and the second. Very good work from Tarek. Stewie chimes in with one as well. Clean sweep for Cloud9. Tarek with four lovely, juicy headshots there. I don't know. Be rushed though, Map. Are you ready?
Smokes out. Flashes as well. Automatic tries to hold it. He will successfully. And the trace pulls all the way to the ground, but then snaps up, finds Cold. He's looking for an ace, and Automatic's got all five. And that was against Guns.
Off the Cloud9. Olaf Meister hasn't exactly been electric so far. He might be able to struggle here. Indeed, he will. But Nico has been fantastic. Three for him, looking for the ace. Headshots all over the place as Nico lights them up to bring in the half. 13-2 in favor of FaZe Clan.
Time and time again. Still not gonna have armor to work with that, but better than nothing. It's Olaf is the man outside of the garage. They're gonna run toward him. Potential for an ace for Olaf in this situation. He's losing a good amount of HP, but no problem. He'll get all five. They made it easy for him.
Clean sweep for Olaf Meister. They line up. He knocks them down.
But they, again, stuck with just the single Olaf. Passing by the archway. Running gun, slow crunch peak potential. Tarek doesn't expect Nico to re-peak, and Nico gets the kill as a result. Rush does get rain, but it's still the advantage to FaZe. As Kerrigan and Olaf set for the crossfire, and Olaf far too easily on the corner is able to take down Skadoodle as well. Rush versus two. Knows that he's there, and he doesn't quite get the pre-fire off because Olaf tried to dictate the peak, but he will get the kill and the bomb down. 5 seconds means that Guardian is going to be pushing Flash out and go too deep. Guardian can stare directly toward him, but he's blinded and actually caught him. And Rush, he's going to win the round for Cloud9.
Four kills for Rush. Surely it's enough, but he gets nothing, Matt. And now the spray has to come in. Nico gets two. 5 seconds, the bomb will go down. Automatic gets the frag. Back and forth we go. And now the two versus one begins. Stewie up against it. Player coming from Bernardo. This kill pretty much decides it. Can he get it? Oh my god, he can. Olaf Meister up against it now.
And he's going to go aggressive on Olaf, who's not going to expect this.
Oh!
How about that? Headset off, and he cheers because that was about as good as you could play it. Automatic gave him help by getting one single kill against Nico, who sprayed down through no smokes. That one. Skadoodle, your turn. You're up. And he's already got the first. He goes. Oh, it's Nico in the smoke as well. He doesn't know it, but he goes back out. He's got it. Oh, my God. How close is that? How fast is Skadoodle? And his turn to stand up. Three in a row in a one versus two.
He rips out the peripherals this time. They're all over the desk.
It's hot. The Rez has again got great control on Banana. Freeze up, get right to be able to get over to the right position at the right time. But you're seeing Dennis again being the damage control. Naff and Steel go down. And Dennis again adjusts further. He's not static. He's not going to rest on his laurels. He wants the action. And my God, is he going to get it? This man is having a big game. And that gets very worrying for Team Liquid.
Might even get the double here. Not meant to be though, but good trades on both sides. 3-on-3, and the bomb is down towards quad.
Shot JW clotheslines NAF. The advantage back as a result for Fnatic and Twist. He's forced out of the pit by Molotovs and smoke, but he's up for the fight. And not only that, he's going to get JW walking through. Twist with a shutdown. You call
the most recognizable names in esports. Please welcome to the stage, it's Fnatic. Everything they have done in the last 2 years has been done in the shadow of that. They are up against possibly the best CS team on the planet. Please welcome FaZe. This tournament has been a journey of revenge. They beat Cloud9 in a double overtime thriller to avenge the Major. Then
one flashbang to try and get him out of position.
Shot Nico immediately.
Not even having to move, you're right. The flashbang, he stands there against the shots off before him.
Oh,
Nico!
God.
How clinical, how perfect.
Golden goes down at 48. And the nades are great there. Nico takes both of them to the face. You can see them working in tandem to find the first pick. That's great from Fnatic.
Working it, goes the angle toward Coffin as well,
right.
But still can't get it. He goes straight toward Golden, unfortunately for him. Flush is far quicker to respond, and he gets Guardian as well. A lot of room to work with toward Banana. Tries to spray in smoke. Gone, Flush it with the ace. Gets off.
Was going to go for the contact play. Is suddenly the last alive.
Oh, this is a done round. Guardian now is the question as to whether he'll save the AWP. Good flashbang. Could get a couple more out of this one. And Fnatic are starting to crumble. What's going on? One player has found three kills. Guardian looking to ace this one out. This could be one of the best rounds of the entire tournament so far. Four kills picked up. It's down to Crimped. This was a 5-versus-1 map. And he's got time as well. The bomb won't be on his back, and he's going for the long con here. Back through T.
Incendiary could be a factor, because if he puts it in front of Guardian, how does he work back in? It's gone toward the dumpster. That means Guardian knows exactly where to look.
Oh!
And he's got all five.
There he is.
Definitely spots him.
Oh, not only does he spot him. Thank you very much.
Oh, wow. No way. No way.
Why did Fnatic anchor this position down? But he has the option to go back to A and look at Flush and go, my
and
God.
That smoke is tantalizing!
Oh! Flusha! He's going to clean out
my
Connector!
Flusha. And he could actually spoil the whole plan as sneaky as Flusha was!
No way!
Oh my God!
That is one of the most impressive clutches you will ever see. Golden from the Academy side of Fnatic. Hats off to him. They've done it again. And they will be champions of Katowice.
Unprecedented and unparalleled. They've walked this walk before, and for the third time, the first ever three-time champions at IEM, they'll walk to the front of the stage, they'll grab the trophy, they've earned it. Fnatic are your IEM Intel Extreme Masters Katowice champions in 2018.